2 lakhs I have given credit, down payment I made 70,000 and I have created liability of 13,000 interest on first installment, and I have paid first installment 53,000. So my closing balance at the beginning of the second year is 90,000. Okay, this 90,000 will be carried forward to next year. Okay, now coming to depreciation account. Depreciation account debit 20,000 to asset account 20,000. My closing balance at the year end is 1,80,000, and this will be carried forward to next year 1,80,000, and depreciation will be debited to P&L, and this will nullify this account. And interest account first I will debit 13,000, and this will be transferred to P&L 13,000. This becomes zero, depreciation becomes zero. My asset balance after depreciation will remain at 1,80,000 at the beginning of the second year, and my liability to vendor will remain at 90,000 at the end of the first year, that is at the beginning of the second year 90,000 will be due. Now let us understand further. Same interest I will carry forward to next year. So next year interest is 9,000 I will credit, and I will make payment of 49,000. So balance will be 50,000 at the beginning of the third year. Okay, same here. Suppose 18,000 if I take depreciation, here depreciation will be 18,000. This I will transfer to P&L 18,000, and my interest is 9,000, and I will transfer this to P&L 9,000. This will get nullified. Okay. Now at the beginning of the second year 50,000, 10% again I will create interest liability. So again I will pay 5,000. Then at the end of the third year I will pay both 55,000 to the vendor, and vendor account will become zero at the end of the third year after I make all the payments. And coming to asset account, I will create depreciation 18,000 for second year, and balance 1,62,000. 1,62,000 beginning of the year, and 16,200 depreciation. 16,200 depreciation. This I will transfer to P&L 16,200, and my interest is 5,000. This I will transfer the interest to P&L. This 5,000. This will become zero. This is zero. Vendor is zero. My asset remains at 1,62,000 minus 16,200. $1,45,800. My asset closing balance remains in my books at the end of the third year. Okay, this is how the entries are done in the books of fire purchase under cash price method. There is another method called interest suspense method. In interest suspense method, there is rest of the entries remain same, and only interest will be recorded at gross at the beginning of the first year itself. Just we will understand that particular aspect. Rest remains the same. Okay. Under interest suspense method. Under interest suspense method, entire interest is being accounted at the first year itself, at the beginning of the year itself. How it will be accounted? Like asset purchase, same asset account debit to hire vendor, down payment hire vendor to bank account. Now I will record interest suspense account. Okay, interest suspense account debit to hire vendor account. Okay, now what I am doing is, this is total of interest. Interest is 27,000. So I am debiting 27,000 interest suspense account. 27,000. This I will do year 0 when I am recording the asset itself. I will create a liability for the gross interest for next 3 years. Here in this example, it is 3 years transaction. So entire 3 years interest has been debited to interest suspense account to hire vendor account. We have created the liability. At the end of year 1, what I will do is I have to pay him 13,000 and I have to debit this 13,000 to my P&L, correct? So now what I will do, year 1 interest account debit to not hire vendor. In cash price method, interest will be credited to hire vendor because I have not created any suspense at the beginning of the year. Here I have already given credit to vendor, so I should not redo credit to hire vendor, it will become double. So what I am doing, interest account I have created the expense. Where is this 13,000 is created? In interest suspense account. So I will reduce this interest suspense account to the extent of it is due, that is 13,000. Okay, because this interest is already fallen due at the end of year 1, so I am reducing that suspense amount of 27,000 by 13,000. Okay, now how this has to be disclosed in financials? Asset side and liabilities. So let us, for the simplicity purpose, let us not carry the depreciation and all. Here asset 2 lakhs, okay, and my liability to the hire vendor will be, what will be the my liability? 2 lakhs plus 2 lakh 27,000. I have created interest suspense 2 lakh 27,000 and I have reduced my interest suspense account by 13,000. So 2 lakh 14,000 will be balance of hire vendor. In this I have paid 70,000 down payment and I have paid 40,000 first installment principal amount. Okay, 1 lakh 10,000. So 1 lakh 4,000 will be there in interest, sorry, hire vendor account. It will be 1 lakh 4,000. Okay, how this 1 lakh 4,000, what is the breakup of this 1 lakh 4,000? It is 90,000 principal and 14,000 interest suspense account. Okay, if you see in the previous cash price method, the closing balance of the hire vendor was 90,000, but here it is reflecting as 1 lakh 4,000 because I have created the interest suspense. So usually the interest suspense account shows debit balance. Okay, in 27,000 which is debited here, it is reduced by credit of 13,000, so it will be 14,000. This will be the balance in interest suspense account at the end of the first year. Okay, so ideally speaking, this 14,000 as interest suspense account to be shown on asset side, but the disclosure has to be like this, like hire vendor account 1 lakh 4,000 less interest suspense account 14,000. So this we will not show it on asset side, rather we will reduce it from the hire vendor and show 90,000 as balance payable to hire vendor. Okay, so what will happen in the second year? Second year, what is the interest? It is 9,000. So what I will do, I will take out 9,000 from interest suspense account and debit it to interest account. Okay, so at the end of the second year, from 1 lakh 4,000, 9,000 interest suspense account will go. So and it will be 95,000. What is the breakup of this 95,000? 90,000 principal and 5,000 interest. in this 90,000 I have paid 40,000 as second installment, 49,000. In 49,000, 9,000 I have identified as interest. So in 90,000, 40,000 is the principal. So my closing balance of hire vendor will be 95,000 minus 55,000 minus 5,000, 50,000 will be my hire vendor closing balance at the end of the second year, that is at the beginning of the first year. On third year, what I will do, I will make the payment of 50,000 and 5,000 of interest, 55,000, which is my hire purchase installment of three, and I will clear the vendor. Okay. Only difference between cash prices and interest suspense method is the interest amount which we will be totally giving credit to hire vendor at the beginning of the hire purchase time only. That is the only difference. Then we will be keep on adjusting the amount from interest suspense account, and that will not be routed through hire vendor account, because we have already credited hire vendor total interest at the beginning of the year. Two things you have to remember. One is period. You have to be very careful while taking note the problem. What is the start date of the hire purchase? If no date is given, just year 1, year 2, year 3 is given, then you can presume it at the beginning of the year, and you can do this way. If they have given any specific date, then you have to be very careful. Proportionately, you have to calculate interest and also depreciation. Suppose 6 months only we have to calculate interest only for 6 months, then how it has to be disclosed in the financials, okay, or how we have to account it. Suppose 1st October 2020 I have purchased, okay. So first year interest is 13,000, and I am closing books of accounts 31st March 2021. So 50%, that is 6 months interest, I have to expense it off. Okay. So the entries remain same. Now for this, how you will show in financials? Okay. Now this 6,500, what you can do is interest accrued but not due 6,500. See, actually as per agreement, you are supposed to pay 1st October 2021 13,000 rupees to the hire vendor, because your installments falls due on after 1 year. Okay. On 1st October 2021, you have to pay 13,000 to hire vendor as a first installment interest. But you are closing your books of accounts on 31st March 2021. So 6 months interest is 6,500. So this 6,500, you cannot create liability and pay to the vendor, because the agreement doesn't say that way. And why should you pay when it is not payable? Okay. So then what you have to do, but you have to record it as expense as an accrual basis. So you will record it as interest accrued but not due 6,500. And this amount you will add to the hire vendor balance, that is 2 lakhs you have purchased, 70,000 you made down payment, so 1,30,000 is the outstanding. You will add up 6,500 and 1,36,500 you will show as outstanding to the hire vendor. Okay. Please understand, we have discussed how accounting entries have done under cash price method and under interest suspense method, and how it has to be disclosed in case the full period interest liability has not come. Okay, that disclosure is this way. I will again explain this point in different way for more clarity. See, you have purchased the asset 1st October 2020. And this is the March 2021, where you are closing your books, but your first installment is due on 30th September 2021. Okay, installment due, and year 0 purchased. So interest is, first year interest is 13,000. Till here it is 6,500. Okay, you need not pay this 6,500 to vendor because you are actually supposed to pay on 30th September 2021. Okay, so for this 6,500, how I will show in books is interest account debit to interest accrued but not due, because this is not due for payment, it is accrued. Okay, this I am recognizing it as expense because this interest is for the period of this financial year, so I am recognizing it as expense and I am crediting it to liability. Okay, this point you have to remember and accordingly you have to make the accounting entries based upon the financial year closure and date of purchase. That you have to remember very carefully. With this I will close today's class, but there is another aspect, that is accounting in the books of hire vendor. Again, accounting in the books of hire vendor, there are two methods. One is sale price method, interest suspense method. It is more or less the same thing, but in the books of hire vendor. Okay, thank you.